What's the peculiar difference between American and European definition of hypertension?
The main difference is the cutoff point, because the American guidelines uses the cutoff point of systolic blood pressure over below 130 over 80. And for us, the definition is still the classical definition of the cutoff point of 140 over 90. The main reason of maintaining the classical definition of blood pressure in Europe and the rest of the world is because there is not enough robust evidence showing that the general population being in this range of blood pressure between 130 and 140 have benefits in reduction of this blood pressure by antihypertensive treatment. Only patients at very high risk have benefits reducing blood pressure, but not the general population. So this is the main reason we have maintained the classical definition as was.
Which are recent updates about hypertension care?
I think our guidelines and also the American guidelines have modified the vision of the approach to antihypertensive treatment. Now the first recommendation for the vast majority of patients is to treat in combination therapy, to start in combination with low dose combination, dual combination, two drugs, using a blockade of the renin-angiotensin system. You may use an ACE inhibitor or an ARB, plus a calcium channel blocker or a diuretic. One important concept in the European guidelines is the recommendation of the use of the beta blockers when there are clinical indications for the use. This means post-MI, heart failure, atrial fibrillation, and also in the young population with hyperactivity of the sympathetic nervous system and mild tachycardia, that the beta blockers in monotherapy may be very useful.